Everything is politics.
Playing rap and hip hop, primarily hip hop.
Punk.
Classic rock. This is the only cool thing about my parents.
Dad.
Anything with soul.
Maybe one or two hip hop records. I'm not really a big fan.
Good music, music that has a meaning, music that actually says something.
I started listening to music when I was way young, listening to like oldies and stuff with grandpops on Saturdays and Sundays, like Sinatra, Dean Martin, and then as I got older, I forget what grade it was, but like MC Hammer came out and I bought the Hammer pants.
You can't touch this.
And I saw, I was like, oh gee, this hip hop stuff is pretty good.
To tell you the truth, one of the first movies was ever watched was Do the Right Thing. My father took me to see Do the Right Thing and they had a Public Enemy fight the power song.
Fight the power!
Press the beat or something, attracted my young mind at the time. The rest is history.
My name is Zoran Siganovic. I live in Huntington Beach. Peter Tosh, that's the trick.
I go old school. I like Al Green, Marvin Gaye, you know, old school cats.
I have Ashley Simpson in my car, I have Black Eyed Peas.
Just the early 90s. Tribe.
Most people you ask, like, how you got into hip hop, most people say Tribe.
Yeah.
And I know that's how I got into it. I'm sure the album was like, oh man. Just tried to find songs that sound like that, and it's all this. Most of the other stuff.
Yep. It's more honest than the commercial stuff.
Yeah.
And then when I moved out to California, somebody gave me a Tupac Greatest Hits CD. And I used to just listen to that all the time.
Now it's all about Versace. You copy my style. Five shots couldn't drop me. I took it and smiled. Now I'm about to set the record straight. With my AK, I'm still the thug that you love to hate.
I take you to the candy shop. I let you lick the lollipop. Go ahead, girl, don't you stop. Keep going till you hit the spot. Whoa!
Rapping wise, Young Jeezy, 50 Game.
When I say hip hop, I definitely don't mean the mainstream or what they're playing on the radio. 50 Cent.
Who don't I like? Like artists like Beyonce, let's say. 50 Cent, maybe. You know what I mean?
I don't know, I'm just not really enjoying too much of today's rap out here. I don't know, like I hear a lot of it, I just don't think it's really quality. Like to me it just sounds like they threw it together just to make a record, just to make money.
Basically back in the day, it was, you know, all about the music, all about the feel of it. It was all about loving hip hop. It wasn't so much about money. Just where I come from the gutter, now I'm, you know, big ballin', whatever. It's so much about I got this many hoes, you know, what you're gonna get, or how much you're out hustling the other person. More than it was about the love for music, for saying something, for speaking about where you come from. Now everybody wants to be a G. It ain't about being a G, it's about music.
Wake up! Take the pillow from your head and put a book in it.
Welcome to the 26th Annual Black Conscious Conference Hip Hop More Than Music. Having a great time. We're defining hip hop. Right now we think hip hop is one of the leading and fastest growing industries. It's a culture. In my opinion, hip hop's a culture. A lot of other people think it's a culture. And currently it defines the black community, and a lot of the younger generation takes on hip hop as an identity as a definition, as their level of consciousness. So we thought that it would be best if we talk about the positive and the negative ways it affects our Black community and what we can do to be progressive with hip-hop. Define, is there a difference between conscious hip-hop and mainstream hip-hop, rap? And that's basically it.
When we talk about hip-hop political movement, we're somehow seeing rap artists like 50 Cent and Jay-Z lead us to a promised land. And nobody is very much sense is talking about that. Why we're getting this white audience for our Black political artists, and why Black political artists with a strong political message are no longer in the mainstream at the level they were. If you understand and remember Chuck D and Public Enemy, they were selling platinum right along their counterparts in their heyday. It wasn't just that they were political, it was that they were political and they were in the mainstream of hip hop. There's no parallel to that now. A lot of times when we start talking about hip hop and politics, older heads seem to think that the corporate industry have us on lock so much that we can't break free of whatever is happening commercially with hip hop.
As long as this drugs to be sold, I ain't waiting for the system to plug up these holes. I ain't slipping through the cracks, so I'm in Portland, Oregon, trying to slip through these raps. The first Black in the suburbs, you think I had ecstasy, Percocet, and plus serve. The way the cops converge, they fucked up my swerve. The first young buck that I serve, I throw it back to the block. I never seen a cop when I was out there, they never came out there. And out there, I was slinging crack to live. I'm only slinging rap to your kids, I'm only trying to show you how Black niggas live. But you don't want your little ones acting like this. Lil Amy told Becky, Becky told Jenny, and now they all know the skinny. Lil Joey got his do-rag on, driving down the street blasting Tupac song. But Billy like Snoop got his blue rag on. Now before you know it, you back in norm. Now the police got me in the middle of the street, trying to beat me blue, black, and orange. I'm like, hold up, who you smacking on? I'm only trying to eat what you snacking on.
Hell yeah.
Y'all like that, do you?
Hell yeah.
You fucked up the hood, nigga, right back to you.
Hell yeah.
You know we tired of starving, my nigga.
Hell yeah.
Let's try.
Yeah,
that's right.
It seems that the movement is still trying to work within a system and still being pushed by a system of capitalism. And can this local, and secondly, can this local manifestation we were talking about have enough influence and power to capture hip-hop from this mainstream?